Hello, 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 everyone, and welcome back to the channel. I apologize that it's been a couple of weeks since you've heard from me, but I have the perfect excuse. Now, part of it is I've been waiting for some information from the Bryan, Texas Police Department, which took about 2 weeks. They really took their time. But, you know, hey, a new friend over there really hooked me up on a ton of information on our religious frauditor, Kristofer Cowles of Half Blind Audits, who we got to take down all of his videos in case you haven't heard. Now, I was working a bunch of overtime so I could take my bride to Barbados for a week as a Valentine gift this year. And man, did we have a blast. We went from 40 degree weather in D.C. to sunny and 85 every day down in the Caribbean. Oh, it was so nice. I was disappointed, though, that the beach water was so cold. But it is what it is. It was nice to lounge around, you know, and let the sun melt the stresses away. Well, then I came home and I got back to the grind and went right back into working long hours at work, of course. But this week, I got some good news from the Bryan Police Department that will expose Kristofer some more, with two more crimes found on him, plus all the times Kristofer has called the Bryan Police Department, which I think you're really going to enjoy. Then, this past week, my good friend Pat Thetic was able to use some of his fancy software and use Wanda Mize's videos against him. And guess what? He has been identified. That's right. After months and months of people asking if I could identify Wanda Mize and do a video about him. So, you know, many, many thanks to Pat for being able to get a name and then an address so that I could do a background check on him. Now, you're not going to believe it, folks. Yep, he's a criminal. He's got a criminal background. Surprise, surprise, huh, folks? Well, so let's get into this video on half-blind audits, Kristofer Cowles. So, go get yourself some popcorn out of the pantry or the kitchen and pop it up as we're getting ready to board the crazy train of frauditing. It's been a couple of weeks since my last update video on half-blind audits, Mr. Kristofer Cowles. Now, if you remember, we got Kristofer Cowles to take down all of his videos on his channel, and we got him to delete all of his alleged supporter comments from the wholly owned and operated website because several of them were fake. Now, it seems that old half-blind audits wasn't as honest as he claimed to be for a deeply religious, devout Catholic. Now, since that time, Pat Thetic and I did some more work, and we looked into Kristofer Cowles' other website, manhusbandanddad.com. Now, Pat Thetic emailed a few of the people on that supporter page, and within hours, the entire website was removed from the internet. And now if you type in the URL for the Man, Husband, Dad website, it redirects you to the wholly owned and operated website. Very interesting, huh? Now, the Man, Husband, Dad website, billed as a nonprofit website and organization, was never even registered with the state of Texas, which makes us go, and wonder what that website and organization was all about. Now, you remember Father Trask, who told us his comments on the wholly owned and operated website were unauthorized? Well, we found the same exact comments on the Man, Husband, Dad website. Now, Pat Thedick let Father Trask know about that, and he sent an email to Kristofer Cowles to remove him and his comment again. So Kristofer Cowles lied about the good father's comments by putting them up on not one, but two different websites. Now, next, it was found that the supporting comments of one Art King, a past chairman of the Chamber of Commerce for Bryan and College Station, Texas, are most likely false also. Now, I say this because Art King passed away on May 6th, 2012, as you can see right here, but the website Man, Husband, Dad was not created by Kristofer Cowles until 2013, as you can see here. So the timeline just doesn't add up that a dead person could endorse a website that was made at least 7 months later. Now, next, on Kristofer Cowles' support page, we found the comments of one Maro Hamza, a past head coach of the Egyptian Olympic fencing team and a renowned fencing coach here in the USA, is a pedophile, who, having actually sexually molested a young girl from the age of 15 years old repeatedly until she was 17 years old, and he got caught. Now, due to these substantiated allegations in an out-of-court settlement with the victim, Maro Hamza has been permanently banned from coaching sports by the U.S. Center for Safe Sports. That's a very interesting choice of supporter you had there, Kristofer. I'm thinking if it was me, I think I would have used someone better than that. So, speaking of websites, I have found two more websites for Kristofer Cowles. One of them is called Half Blind Justice, as you see here, and the other is kdncnews.com, which, as you can see, they have absolutely nothing on either one of them. Now, I don't know if Kristofer Cowles took everything off of these websites due to being exposed. Excuse me. Now, all four of these websites that Kristofer Cowles has, Pat Thedick has found they are all hosted on one server, which begs this question. Is Kristofer Cowles using a tax-deductible 501c3 not-for-profit for the cover for at least two websites which have nothing to do with the wholly owned and operated website and organization? Only Kristofer Cowles knows, and he refuses to provide the correct financial documents that Pat Thedick has requested so that we could tell. How is that for transparency, folks? What a hypocrite Kristofer Cowles is turning out to be. So speaking of Kristofer Cowles not providing the requested financial documents of the wholly owned and operated website and organization, it's been over 30 days since the request was made. So Kristofer Cowles is in violation of Texas not-for-profit laws and also IRS rules and regulations and federal laws. Complaints have now been filed with the Texas Attorney General's Office and with the Internal Revenue Service. It really seems that Kristofer Cowles' egotistical and narcissistic personality wants to fight for transparency until it comes to him and his not-for-profit corporations. Oh no, then Kristofer Cowles wants to become a tyrant and refuse to be transparent. Isn't that quite hypocritical, folks? Well, Kristofer Cowles' wife, Elizabeth, was contacted recently because being listed as the president of wholly owned and operated, she's just as responsible as Kristofer Cowles for the financial documents that were requested. And since it's been proven that Kristofer Cowles hides things from his wife, Elizabeth, we wanted to contact her directly so that she had a chance to respond. But so far, she has not responded either. So, while we were doing some more digging on Kristofer Cowles, I found two more criminal charges against him from back in January of 1992. Kristofer had one charge for speeding, which was 80 in a 55 mile per hour zone. And then Kristofer Cowles failed to appear for his court date, so a failure to appear charge was also applied. Now, in 1995, when Kristofer Cowles found the Lord and was baptized and changed his life, do you think he did the right thing and make amends? Do you think he took responsibility for his past transgressions? Not a chance, folks. He waited until he was arrested again in 2001 and was forced by the courts to answer the charges. Unfortunately, the court dropped those two charges in favor of holding him responsible for five charges he picked up in 2001. That, again, he tried to skip out on, if you guys remember correctly. So we did a little digging on Kristofer Cowles' FOIA requests at the Bryan Police Department, and come to find out he's made 21 FOIA requests in the past 2 years, which has resulted in Bryan government employees spending 20 hours on his nonsense. So I made a new friend in Bryan, Texas, as I mentioned earlier, and guess what I was able to get a hold of? Now, Kristofer Cowles talks bad about the Bryan Police Department, and he says he doesn't hate cops, but he sure acts like he does. So, you know what? Did you know that he's made 35 calls to the Bryan Police Department in the past 10 years? Yes, folks, 35 calls, like they're his own private police force, to tell teenage kids to stop cursing as they walk down the street, or because kids were riding scooters down the street, or his dogs were barking at a car or a truck that was on the street, or that a neighbor put boxes out by the street for recycling pickup, and the wind blew them out into the street, or that people were parking on both sides of the street to attend a garage sale, or calling the police twice in 2020, to report people in stores weren't wearing masks to protect from the COVID virus. And my favorite was in September of 2023, when Kristofer Cowles went to the Bryan Police Station and demanded to place a criminal trespass warning on a police officer and his wife in retaliation for the police officer giving Kristofer Cowles criminal trespass warnings for two schools at his wife's request. That's the police officer's wife, who was the principal and complainant, because Cowles was at the schools filming children in the schools, police activity from the schools. Not only is Kristofer Cowles filming schools, he's filming Catholic schools, which is supposed to be his religion. Is that why you and your friend went to the Cypress Grove Intermediate School in College Station to film in January of 2024, Kristofer? Causing the school to go into a lockdown because they had no idea what you two weirdos were up to? Good job, Kristofer, scaring little children like that. You should be so proud of yourself. Now, I do have to remember to call the College Station police tomorrow and see if they will tell me if you and or your friend received a criminal trespass warning for that little stunt. There may have to be a part four to this series on exposing half-blind audit, folks, just because more information keeps getting found. Now, I find it very interesting that a Catholic school named St. Joseph's would bar you from their property, Kristofer. Now, with the, you know, you being such a devout Catholic and all, something seems a little fishy to me. Now, if you're watching this, Kristofer, could you please reply in the comment section below and tell us if there's any truth to the rumor that your wife, Elizabeth, was asked to leave the employ of St. Joseph's School because of your filming and your creepiness while you were at the school? Or do I have the school wrong, Kristofer? You know how rumors are, Kristofer. Someone might be giving me bad information, but I want to hear the truth straight from the mouth of who will know, and that's you, sir. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be the end of part three of the series of Half-Blind Audits, Mr. Kristofer Dylan Cowles of Bryan, Texas, where we got to expose his frauds just a little bit more with some more criminal charges and, you know, some more hypocritical statements that he makes. Where, you know, just, you know, and his First Amendment activity is really a fraud. And we're really beginning to believe that this whole devoutly religious facade is a fraud also. Now, Kristofer Cowles really needs to take this time and do some deep reflection on where he wants to go from here. He can't continue to play the deeply religious devout Catholic on one hand and play frauditor and fraud on the other hand. Remember, Kristofer, I told you what you do in the darkness will surely be exposed in the light. All I wanted to do was talk to you, Kristofer, show you the error of your ways, and you blew me off. So I had to show the whole world what you were really, really all about. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming to watch this latest video, and of course, I hope you enjoyed it. You know what to do. Hit the thumbs up button to show that you like this video. Comment down below on what you think of Kristofer Cowles and his life of a fraud. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, please do so now so that you get to see all the new content coming up in the near future. Remember to back the blue, folks, because 25 law enforcement officers and 4 police dogs have given their life already in 2024 protecting you. Not to mention all of the law enforcement officers out there who've been assaulted in the first 9 or 10 weeks of 2024. I'm really starting to see areas in the USA who are getting sick of all this crime and everything that the criminal justice reform and the bail reform produced for everyone. So I am glad to see that finally that people are getting sick of it. That's all I have for now, folks. So next time, y'all take care.